Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of Bake with Shivesh and Komal.
Thank you so much for having me.
This is one collaboration that I've been dying to make it happen. So I'm so glad finally. And it's a super interesting concept. What we're doing today is basically a breakfast date with Komal. And so in this video, we're doing three very quick healthy breakfast recipes. Uh-huh. So, you know, I am someone who's happy eating a slice or two of chocolate cake for breakfast. But since you were coming,
we thought we'll do
something healthy, which is equally delicious and fun. And very simple. So, and the best part is that this is all still very delicious.
Yeah.
So hopefully something that, you know, you'd still enjoy eating for breakfast. Yeah. So should we get started? Let's go. Chalo, so the first recipe that we're doing is a double chocolate granola.
Okay.
And it's a very good mix of a lot of seeds, and we have oats going in and quinoa going in.
There's
no wheat flour. So it's also gluten free if you're using gluten free oats. So, Komal, I think you could do this recipe. It's very simple.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I definitely think you can do it.
I'm very nervous.
Go for it. So, in this bowl, we'll start by adding quinoa. Okay. So, this is your regular white quinoa.
Okay.
So, all of this into the bowl.
Like how many spoons?
No, all of it.
Oh.
So, just empty out the bowl. It's all measured.
You know what? I'm going to show this video to my mother.
Yeah.
She might have happy days.
Domestic goddess.
For sure.
So, after this video, the Komal that will walk out of the studio would be like a domestic goddess, making mom proud.
Oh,
and the oats.
Now
we'll probably get rishtas. All of it. Oats into the bowl, yeah. And to this, we'll add the flax seeds.
Okay, all of it?
Yeah.
So this is how much exactly?
Abhi measurement yaad nahi hai mujhe.
Aur ye flax seeds kaha se aate?
Yeah, this is your regular flax seeds. So the flax seeds.
I always swear.
I consume flax seeds. Yeah.
Okay? But I always thought flax seeds must be like green in color.
No, no. This is of the pumpkin seeds are green, which we'll also add to the.
So all this while I thought this.
So you're eating pumpkin seeds, but you're thinking you're eating flax seeds.
You know those mixed berries and.
It comes with a trail mix type of situation. So pumpkin seeds are usually there in the. No, so these are flax seeds and those are pumpkin seeds. So this is a mix of pumpkin seeds and chia seeds and sesame seeds and sunflower seeds.
Okay,
so all of that goes in. And to this I'm adding flax seeds.
Wow.
Right? The best part about this recipe is that you could use and throw in whatever seeds you have at home.
Oh, nice.
So you don't need to particularly look for these.
All
could be pine nuts, anything. So anything that you think would add a nice crunch. We'll also add walnuts to the recipe. You can add pecans or anything.
And
I think
almonds and all. Whatever
almonds. I think just chocolate, walnuts and pecans go really well together.
Okay.
And to just add some more flavor, we're doing ginger powder.
Can I smell this?
Yeah.
I have a really bad habit of smelling.
Smelling everything before
and
you
mom
put it in.
Me every time. Yeah. She's like, can you not? It's really bad etiquette.
No, it's actually a very interesting thing to do. And this is the cinnamon.
Oh, wow. This is ginger.
So
something.
Ginger powder.
What is nutmeg?
Nutmeg is basically this round kind of a.
What is it in Hindi?
Jaifal. So you can also actually grate in the nutmeg, and the zest of the fresh nutmeg would be great.
Mm-hmm.
And cinnamon powder to this.
Yum.
And I'll just mix this in.
Okay, so you're gonna bind all of this with what?
With honey. So you could either use honey or maple syrup. So I'll mix the cocoa powder in.
Iska bhi kuch technique hota hai?
Nahi, just very simple. It's basically throw everything in and mix it together, kind of a situation happening.
Yeah.
And to this, we'll add the honey.
Okay.
So all of this.
Okay, great. This is so satisfying.
But what's your usual breakfast like if
like
at home on a regular work day?
So I wake up, I have some detox water with like ajwain and chia.
Yeah.
Like
so you tea. Infuse it overnight or?
No.
So you boil it, okay.
Boil ke chai ki tarah.
Haan.
And then I have one egg.
Okay.
And then I either have like oats chila, besan chila. Or I have this really nice granola that I got.
Okay.
It's gluten free. I have that with almond milk.
Oh, nice.
Just that, and then uske ek ghante baad I have like mutti bhar ke dry fruits.
Okay.
And then my lunch.
All right. So this is it, and now to this, just to make our chocolate granola, double chocolate granola, we have some dark chocolate chips.
Okay.
And we'll just throw these in as
Also, the chocolate that you put.
Yeah.
Is that healthy?
So if you're using dark chocolate, it is. It's just also to kind of make it, like, I wouldn't categorize it as healthy. And yeah, like some, and it's not like it's too much. So even if you take one serving, you'd probably end up having what, like 5 or 6 chocolate chips, which is fine. It's acceptable. All right, Komal, so the granola is actually done. And the oven's preheating at 180 degrees Celsius. I'll transfer this on a baking tray lined with silicone mat and then bake this for about 30 to 35 minutes. Yum?
Yum. Love it.
All right, so this is ready for the oven. All right, so our granola is in the oven and we'll get started on our mixed berry banana smoothie.
Okay.
Because we all want smoothie for breakfast, right? So we have a couple of mixed berries here, frozen ones, raspberries and blueberries, strawberries, some bananas. So for smoothies, I always try and freeze my fruits in advance.
Oh, wow.
So if you make them very often, it just gives my this thing a more creamy texture, my smoothies.
Oh,
and also that it then immediately makes my smoothie cold. And that's how I like eating my smoothies. Like, I want them to be cold.
Yeah.
So instead of adding ice to make them cold, because then
it's
at the end of
better,
it, it's just water.
Yeah.
So just freeze your fruit and you'll have like a nice, smooth, creamy smoothie. All right. So we'll just put everything into the mixer directly. You want to come this side and do it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do I put?
All right, so all the berries first.
Oh God, gir jayega.
Here, take this.
Yeah.
And to this we are adding soy milk. So here you go.
Yum.
And we have some frozen bananas. One frozen banana, actually.
Fun fact, my favorite fruit's banana. And
yeah.
The only fruit I'm not supposed to eat.
Why?
Because it's fat.
Really? Okay, and this is Greek yogurt. I am not a fan of eating bananas just like that, but I love them in my desserts. So if you give me a banana bread or a banana cake with caramel, I'll be happy eating it.
I love dry cakes the most.
Yeah. Simple ones, no fuss, no frosting.
Yeah.
All right, and to this we'll add just
honey?
Some maple syrup now this time, since we know it's healthy now.
Wow. Yeah, so all this while, everywhere I go, whenever I order pancakes, I specifically tell
no maple syrup.
Okay, listen, don't give me maple syrup. I'm like, oh God, I'm so healthy.
But it's so yum also. Yeah.
It's yum. And then I ask for honey as an alternative. Fun fact, I hate honey.
Oh, really?
I don't like honey.
All right, so the smoothie is ready.
It's done?
It's done, so simple.
Oh my God, I can't
just throw everything. Yet. And I think that's the best part about the breakfast recipes, right? Because they need to be quick.
Yeah,
I'm sure everyone have things to do in the morning. And we'll pour this into a bowl. And the color is so pretty, right? Of your not so favorite strawberry. Smoothie is ready to use. We'll wait for the granola to get done so that we can top the smoothie with some granola and more fresh fruit and then eat it. And so should we move on to the next recipe? And next recipe is one of my favorite breakfast recipes, which is classic pancakes. And we're doing a lemon and chia seed flavor to it. So lemon chia seed pancakes, let's make those now. So we'll start by adding our flour. So this is a mixture of whole wheat and oat flours.
All right.
Yeah. So that goes into a bowl.
Okay.
And to this, some baking powder. And to this, we're adding 2 tablespoons of sugar. Of course, if you want to avoid sugar, you can just add jaggery. That works
or
equally
like
well.
Coconut sugar
is equally good. So just mix this well with your beautiful golden whisk.
I have never done this.
Whisking for the first time.
This is how you do it?
Yeah. Perfectly fine.
Okay.
Chalo, this is done, and now we'll start working with the wet ingredients in a separate bowl.
Yeah.
So the soy milk. And to this we're adding olive oil.
Okay.
Done. And 1 egg. So the egg that you eat for breakfast is going into the pancakes today. And now, again, using the whisk, just mix it well. So this is your usual basic pancake recipe. Now we'll just add some flavor of lemon to it. So I'll add lemon juice to the wet ingredients and fresh lemon zest to the dry ingredients.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. Wow, More, na?
Yeah. So just about a teaspoon of lemon juice coming in from a sriracha bottle. And meanwhile, I'll zest the fresh lemon zest.
What is zest?
So that's basically the yellow part of the lemon.
The chilka.
So the chilka of it. And I'll use this grater, or you could use a zester.
Yeah.
Grate this in finely into the batter.
So this is also known as a zester.
No, this is not a zester. This is just a grater.
But you get a mic.
So kaddukas karenge nimbu ka chilka iske andar.
Amazing.
And zester is slightly different. And yeah, so you can eat the yellow skin of the lemon. And that really gives it a nice flavor and freshness.
I can eat it.
The zest. Yeah. So what you could also do is, I don't think you'd enjoy this way of eating it.
Yeah.
But what we also do is like take like larger peels of it and then we candy it in sugar. So it's like nice and chewy and super flavorful and coated with sugar. So it's easy to make. It takes a lot of time on the saucepan because then you cook it with sugar. And you basically...
It's caramelized.
So it basically... No, it doesn't caramelize, but it becomes nice and crystallized, the sugar on this thing. Yeah, it's when the sugar becomes golden brown, that is caramelizing. But when you're candying this thing, then it becomes crystallized and it sticks to the lemon peel
of it.
You eat it, so like the sourness of the lemon with the crystallized sugar makes for a really nice candy. Alright, so the lemon zest into the dry ingredients. So this goes in and just mix this and then add the dry ingredients into the wet ingredients. That's your pancake batter. And we'll add 2 tablespoons of chia seeds towards the end. Yeah, so these are chia seeds and we'll add these towards the end. All right, let's do this. Keep mixing. Thoda complicated ho gaya. Yes. So this is your batter, nice and smooth.
Can I smell it again?
Haan, go for it. All the lemony goodness.
What it smells like?
What?
Yaad nahi aa raha.
Nimbu only.
Something very nostalgic. It reminds me something that my mother used to make as a child. I don't know what is it. It's probably the nimbu that's giving the nostalgia. I don't know.
And.
Oh yes, it's what? Nothing to eat. Basically, when I was, I think, 15 years old, my mother used to give me besan and nimbu or
dahi ka leaf. Okay, for your face mask. Yeah.
It smells the same.
Yeah, I think because of the lemon. I do that face pack.
Yes.
I think that's all Indian mom's ka staple recipe. So now 2 tablespoons of chia seeds. So when I was in college, so school I used to still eat breakfast because mom used to force me ke without drinking milk and without eating anything, you can't step out of the house. But once I got into college is when I became thoda sa rebellious. I used to always skip breakfast because as in morning, I just don't feel like eating much.
That happens.
And second year then chia seed pudding became like my staple breakfast because it's delicious. Yeah, so I used to make it at night because it needs to set in the refrigerator overnight. So my mom used to bake a lot. Now she stopped because there's only so much sugar a family can consume, obviously. So now she's stopped. She's taken a back seat on that front. But she still does all the cooking, so that's something that I don't plan to take on anyway. Not at all. Only dessert.
Mm-hmm. Like nothing?
Nothing at all. I can only make Maggi like almost all the people my age. Yeah.
Oh.
And so I'm just preparing the pan for our pancakes. Just brushing it lightly with olive oil.
Okay.
And so that we can get the pancake started. Alright, so the pan's hot and now Komal, we have the pancake challenge for you where you attempt making the pancake. Let's see how it goes. It is slightly tough and especially the first pancake. So as a rule, the first pancake's never pretty enough.
Got it.
Alright, so just scoop the batter out. Yeah. And now onto the pan. Just empty it out completely. Not bad.
It's really bad. Don't be so
and
nice.
Yeah, done. I love how you have to taste and smell everything.
I love.
Ye thode se extra dots ho gaye hain. These we can probably get rid of.
Give me now.
Half cooked batter. It's not raw, it's not cooked. 1 second, I'll just clean the...
Oh my god, I love it.
Nice?
I love it.
Alright, so now we'll wait for the lower part to cook slightly and we'll then flip the pancake and cook the other side. Komal, not bad, yeah?
Yeah.
This looks really nice.
It's just by mistake.
Just by chance.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Can't stop eating the batter only. And the chia seeds add like a nice crunch to the pancakes, like a little texture. So that's really fun. Of course, you can add poppy seeds or whatever seeds that you like to the pancake.
Lemon is not dominating.
Yeah,
it's
subtle. All right.
So I'm from Bihar. And हमारे यहाँ ना festivals पे we make this thing called pua.
Okay.
It's very close to malpua.
Malpua. Yeah. But it's not the same thing.
It's but it looks like.
Oh, but no, I'm saying different. Like what you make is malpua. Like is that similar to malpua?
It's the same thing.
It's the same thing. Okay.
But it's like deep fried.
So you've removed the word mal.
We call it pua.
Okay.
We call it pua. And
so they look similar.
Reminds
yeah.
me of that, but it's just like extremely rich. I think it's like a healthy
That version. One's fried in sugar syrup and
pura, yeah. So it's fried and then you make sugar syrup alag se. So once you're
okay.
done frying, you
and
put
then you
it,
put more.
And then you have to let it stay for like a couple
so
of
So it nicely soaks in all the sugar
like
syrup.
A few pounds just by talking about
Heart
it.
Attack on a plate. I love it, but it's one of my favorites. Okay. My nani used to make it at home. And yum.
And it's very tough to make.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, not for you.
No, I've never made it. Like, I don't even know what the procedure is
but
like.
But you're like the dessert king, so not
no,
for you.
No, but like, I've never attempted making also.
But what I've heard
also.
About desserts and cakes and all is that it's tough because of the quantities. Most people get
No, see, again, I
wrong.
In fact feel like it's very simple because of that. Because cooking, then you throwing things on your own.
Yeah.
So that is difficult to get. If you have a nice, trusty recipe and you only have to follow the set measurements, it's actually pretty simple to do.
We did add an egg to it, right? What if someone's like a pure vegetarian?
So if you don't want to add egg, what you could do is use the flax seeds.
I want to taste that.
Yeah, go for it. So the flax seeds that we added to the granola,
yeah.
just powder those flax seeds, add water to it, mix it really well and what you get is a flax egg.
Yeah.
So you can use the flax egg instead of your regular egg.
Got it.
And that works really well. Anyway, what the egg is really doing here is binding everything together. So the flax egg does that perfectly well. So our first pancake is done and we'll make a few more. So that we have a nice stack, and as they say, and by they I mean I say, a stack of pancakes shared with friends is.
I don't know, after that, but I've heard of it.
Is time well spent and deliciousness tasted well. What is it?
I don't know. Okay, but we get your emotions.
You get my emotions, get right? Yeah. So we need a stack of pancakes, basically.
I also want to say something funny and yeah. like personal. And
go for it. Go for it.
As a child with my mother, I used to watch Khana Khazana all the time.
Oh, yeah. Sanjeev, that's all of us. Yeah. Sanjeev Kapoor.
Kapoor.
Yeah.
I always call him Kumar for some reason. Yeah.
That's an actor, Sanjeev Kumar.
Yeah, I love Sanjeev Kumar, by the way. But okay. So I used to watch it and in their special episodes mein, they used to get like guests.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
would
yeah.
just stand like this and he would explain. And I used to always think,
ki ek bar main bhi aise show mein.
Yeah. This is like my dream.
That's your Khana Khazana like, moment
yeah,
happening.
Yeah, you're like my Sanjeev Kapoor.
Honored. I know, so cute, yeah. but that's so true. Like even I used to watch
Dude,
Khana Khazana all the time.
Like
and I hope someone's listening. Netflix, yeah. Get in touch. We need to make it happen. So Komal up on the pancake stack. I'm just adding some blueberries.
Okay.
So these are frozen blueberries. And we'll drizzle this with some maple syrup.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And now let's assemble our smoothie bowl. So we have a few fresh fruits and our chocolate granola.
Okay.
Is yeah, so we can put the chocolate granola towards this side. Let's also taste the chocolate granola. I love this. Actually, if I was into healthy snacking, I think this would be my go-to.
Oh my god. so good.
It could be such a nice snack, right? Like, so just good. Make a big batch of it, keep it stored in an airtight jar, and just keep munching on it whenever you're hungry. And you like coconut, right?
I love coconut.
So some desiccated coconut to add color and flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And then your favorite bananas.
I love
and
bananas.
Strawberries on top. So that's our breakfast spread for the day. Let's go for it.
Please.
So the mixed berry banana smoothie with double chocolate granola.
This is the best smoothie bowl I've tried.
Yeah?
I'm not kidding. I will not lie. I will never lie. Oh my god. So good. This is heaven.
And you could taste a lot of banana. So I think for someone who likes banana.
Oh my god. So good.
Komal approved, right?
I can have breakfast all day now if this is the breakfast.
Yeah. And now, our healthy pancakes.
Mm.
Let's see how these are. So I haven't made them very often.
Okay.
So for me, this is a new this thing as well. So let's see how this tastes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. How can I not like anything which is lemon and blueberry?
Oh my god.
And I think, you know what does the trick here is the lemon zest.
It's so fluffy.
Yeah.
I love it.
And the kick of the lemon zest, I think, is what adds most of the flavor.
Yum. It's yum.
So we like the pancakes also.
Like.
Awesome.
So good. So good.
So Komal's liked all the three things that we made for breakfast today, and all these recipes will be available on my website bakewithshavesh.com. I'll leave the link in the description box below. And thank you so much, Komal, for this breakfast date with me. And I hope we'll do a lot of recipes together for sure. Yeah. Awesome. So guys, keep watching. I'll be back with another video next week.
And subscribe.
And subscribe.
Hit the bell button, please.
Yeah, all of these things I need to learn from you, Komal. Please tell me.
Subscribe, hit the bell button, and he'll be back soon with another video.
Yeah. Bye.